Okay, so we'll shortly be starting with the webinar. Now in terms of signature as a product, I hope I am audible to everybody and everybody is also able to. In terms of signature as a product, signature is a blockchain-based product. And basically for all your signings, maybe it is invoices or maybe from the HR perspective, it might be offer letters and increment letters that you might be wanting to sign or joining letters. Internship offers. So all of these documents from the HR perspective, in terms of legal as a department, you might be coming across a lot of other documents like your NDAs and your agreements and multiple other reports. As CAs also, you might be coming across various audit reports that you need to sign, the 50 CA CB forms that you need to sign, the statutory audit reports that you need to sign. So these are various multiple use cases that you might be coming across day in and day out. In order to have it securely signed and now this has to be done remotely. The challenge is being that most of the guys are working from home now. You might be having the challenge of how will you exactly sign it without a dongle? Because dongle would be a hardware that you might be connecting it with the computer or might be at a remote location somewhere. There is a signer who also needs to sign it. So due to various such challenges that we're facing, signature is the perfect product that will be fitting your current requirements. I'll be moving to what signature exactly is, and then further we'll shift to the challenges that Mr. Sagar from our team will also highlighting as a chartered accountant. So in terms of signatures and signings that are done currently, maybe in terms of the vetting signatures or the sign that you are doing manually, you might be coming across challenges of how will you be able to sign and further print it. If you're printing it, there are multiple copies to be signed of the same single document. Why would you waste much time and effort to also sign these kind of documents? You need to further scan it and email it to your clients. Then the whole process of this signing can be automated, the printing, the signing, the scanning, as well as the emailing. Why would you actually spend so much of time with the manual signatures? In terms of the uses of even paper, because you'll have to use the paper, you'll have to get the hard copies done, you'll have to print them, you have to sign and further courier it and stamp it. So this involves a lot of cost to be inculcated. Even when it comes to storing of these documents and storing of these hard copies, there is a cost which is there behind it for storing these documents as well. In terms of e-signing solutions which are currently present, it is quite possible that it only authenticates the email address and not the actual person who's signing it. So like the signature of the person who's signing it only might be authenticating the email address. So this provides an insufficient document protection. And apart from that, it is quite possible that these documents also might get tampered. So it is very important to see when it comes to huge documents or huge reports that you need to sign or maybe huge agreements that you need to sign, that all of these documents are not tampered. There are no changes that the other party is making. If at all they are making any changes further to the signed copy, you might get a notification of the same that these are the changes made. So such kind of warnings or notifications you might not receive. And this is where it is difficult to handle such changes and challenges. So it's better to move to a solution that is much more secure, that uses such a platform wherein you will be able to have tamper-proof documents. So signature basically is a blockchain-based product. We use Ethereum in the background. And here is when we'll also be having a tamper-proof mechanism wherein in case there is no such document that any of the user will be able to tamper. Further, in terms of signing, we have multiple options. So we have e-signing in place, we have biometrics in place. You can use a fingerprint to actually sign a document. Similarly, you will also be able to use an iris scanner. There's a video conferencing which is there available. So these are the various kind of signs or signature options or offerings that we have available, which I'll walk you through. And this is a process which will be totally automated and easy. So in terms of when we talk about signature, it's an award-winning product. So we have won the best blockchain-based award in the recent Viden IT Summit, which was held in 2018. and it is based on the technology blockchain, and it has advanced encryptions and crypto identities in place. Also, in terms of how you will be able to use it and how secure it is, we'll walk you through the security aspects as well. In terms of the range of signatures that we have, the first being the USB token or the dongle. So if you want to sign using a dongle, that is one option. There is a second option, which is the certified sign. So basically, a certified sign, we are tied up with Global Sign. So all your signatures that you do online, you have an option of drawing the signature or maybe selecting any font related to the name of yours, uploading any image of it. All of these three options are available for electronic signing. And further, this sign will be certified by Global Sign. And this is globally acceptable and legal. The next is biometric as a signature. So you can use the fingerprint scanning machine. It's a small hardware that needs to be attached with your laptop or desktops. And you will be able to sign any specific document you require. Further, if in case you also want facial recognition signature, that is also an option available. Then there is an iris scanner. All of these signings, whether it is fingerprint or facial recognition or iris scanner, you require small hardwares which are related to it. Further, the same can be signed. The documents can be signed using the same. In terms of further documents wherein you also want the government or national ID signatures, currently we have an Aadhaar e-sign. So this calls for the Aadhaar APIs which are there with the government, and further it will be validating that this is the specific Aadhaar related to this person, and a signature will be placed in the document if you have opted for the Aadhaar electronic signature. Similarly, we have it for the Emirates ID as well. In case of live signature, it's a full video conferencing experience and the video that we store further. And each and every of these signatures will have the hash which will be stored in the blockchain. So as soon as a document is uploaded on this platform on signature, a hash will be created and stored. Further, this cannot be tampered because it is already stored in one of the blockchains. So further, when you are signing this specific document, the signed copy is also created as a hash, and this hash can be further stored and the certificate can be downloaded from this application. So this is the whole process. Even at the time of entering your credentials, you will be asked for an OTP, which will again be one of the signs of security. So these are the various signature types based on how you require it. This can happen with multiple fonts. If you want to sign it with a finger, you can have it drawn. Similarly, if you want to upload an image, the same can be uploaded. If you just want a certified sign by Global Sign, this is the signature which is valid. You will be able to do it over here. If in case you want an Aadhaar e-sign or maybe signed by a photograph, you can upload an image, or maybe by the iris scanner or a fingerprint. So all of these are various prototypes of the various offerings as signature that we provide. We also capture the latitude as well as the longitude. So you will be able to have an eye on where the person is signing from, which location exactly. So in some of the industries, it's a mandate that these are the specific documents for which you need to sign from a particular place. So in that case, we have tied up with Google Maps, and according to the maps, the latitude and the longitude will be captured, and you will be able to see the exact location from where the specific document has been signed. Here, you will be able to have live signatures done. So as a in-person live meeting as we are having right now, both the parties can be there present at the same time and sign the document, whether they are belonging to different time zones and maybe vast far away from one country to the other. You can have a conversation and a signing both recorded on the video itself. So this is the live signature that the whole video can be captured further. And this is again a legally admissible as per the court. Now all these signatures, once the document has been signed, a hash has been created, a certificate is prepared, and this certificate further will have all the necessary information related to the document. So you will be having a hash of the document uploaded as well as the document signed, when the document was uploaded as well as where it is signed, What is the latitude longitude? What is the IP address of the specific device? Which device was used? Which was the browser that was used? And the date, time, and stamp. So all of these are the document information and the signing information that gets stored in each and every certificate. So more or less, this covers most of the requirements, whether it is various types of signing or various other types of information and security perspectives that you might require. So in terms of features, we have a dashboard or statistics that how many are the total documents that have been uploaded for you to sign, how many have you sent further, maybe for signings and approvals, or if you want a specific signer to sign first and then you want there are separate observers who can just observe the document. So in one of the use cases where you might have maybe interns or article ship holders who might be wanting to you to just help observe one of the documents they are working on, they can keep themselves as the observers and you as the signer. Similarly, when we are talking about what all file formats can this application actually work on, so you can upload all the PDF documents or the Word documents, the PPT, the Excels, and all of these documents and formats can be further signed. The signing process might have the due date functionality, all the notifications, so you might get reminders if you have set up a specific date to a signing as well. So if you have mentioned 30th as the last day for signing, and if you want that the other party who has to sign will receive emails and reminders for the same, all of those other features are possible, and you might be able to share these notifications with them with a personal or private message as well. Say suppose you also want to upload supporting documents to a specific document you want to sign, that is also possible. If you want to reassign a specific document or maybe decline a document due to some or the other reason, you can do that as well. And at the time of declining, you will be able to also write a message that why or the reason of your why you are declining that particular document to be signed. There are various templates that you will be able to create and reuse. There are multiple signers you can select. So basically, if you want maybe 10 people who are to sign that specific document, it is quite possible. If you want that maybe two of these people have to sign first and then the rest of the people will be able to sign, all of those permutations and combinations can be configured in the settings as an option. Parallel signing or co-sign also is possible. At the time of creating the document, immediately also you will be able to sign. As we discussed, there is a location binding. So the latitude and the longitude can be also tracked at the time of signing of any specific document. You can also share these documents further for anybody's access, but you will be having a track of who accesses it, where do they exactly access that, and the signing procedure as well. In case you want an AD integration and Active Directory integration for the organizational use and ease of use, that is also possible. We do have a mobile application, and it is very easy to sign. It is just a quick four step wherein you already have your account, or maybe you can log in as a guest. And further, once you log in, the document will be available to you for signing. So you can click on the signing as an option. You just need to select any of the sign, maybe certified or whichever sign the counterparty has initiated the document with. So you can just select that signing, and the document gets signed and a certificate gets created, which you can download it further. So you can receive the document, download the document, as well as there in the background, the hash will already be created. We have had a lot of use cases wherein people have actually integrated signature with third-party other solutions. So we have APIs, enriched APIs, which can be further integrated with business systems and multiple other third-party softwares as well. The whole audit trail is what we track. So each and every time a document gets uploaded or signed further, all of these trails are maintained in the document, maintained in the application as well. Further, these documents can verify. So if in case there is a document which you have already stored, if you want to compare the two documents, once it is signed and before it was signed, that comparison or verification is also possible. And as we discussed, multiple signing and multiple signers. you can select it from the application itself. So as a five-step process, you just need to upload a file. Further, you need to select the signers who will be signing. You need to select a place of where they will be signing in the document. Third step is, which signature do you want to go forward with for the document, whether you want an e-sign or maybe a fingerprint or an iris scanner or a face recognition, etc. You need to decide a place where you want this signature to be kept. And further, the blockchain stamping, which is the actual document that gets stored under the blockchain. So in terms of the security, we have a user ID and a password. These are the credentials for you to log in. You will only be able to log in with the help of an OTP. So this is the first step of secure logging in. The next is, whenever we are talking about any signing that is happening, we will be having captured the IP address of the device. We will also be capturing the device that had been used, the location, which is the latitude and longitude, as well as, if required, the biometrics as well. All the digital signings that are happening or the sign which are there will be having a crypto ID as well. And this proof of transaction that has happened of uploading the document as well as sharing and signing of the document will be stored under the blockchain. Again, this is encrypted data in the database. So this is the whole application security structure like. And again, this application is ISO VAPT certified. So all the security parameters are already mapped. Talking about how the signature is currently being used across the industries, across various departments and various functions. So when we are talking about sales as one of the departments, you have multiple sales contracts and NDAs and invoices that needs to be signed and shared further. So these are some of the documents when we are talking about sales department. In terms of purchases, there are POs that need to be signed as well as NDAs that need to be signed, some of the purchase contracts that need to be signed further. So these are the documents related to purchases. Apart from that, when we are talking about the legal as a department, they might be having NDAs and agreements and stamp papers further, which they will also need to sign. In terms of HR, they'll have various other documents like offer letters and vendor contracts. In terms of the operations, they might have work orders and project specific some of the documents. They might be having delivery challans that are required to be signed. Further, they might be having payment slips that need to be signed or multi-party agreements. And in terms of finance, there might be invoices and other financial documents that need to be signed. So this is a signature as an application can fix under various departments. And of course, this works on a user ID basis. So you can have a user ID specific to a department or maybe a specific to a person. That depends upon your requirement exactly and how do you want to place it. And it goes across the industries. So we have currently multiple clients who already have opted for the same. I'd like to check if Sagar is available now and if we can further have his challenges addressed and we can understand what all challenges that he is facing. So give us a moment. Meanwhile, we'll wait for 2 more minutes. If you have any questions or queries, you can post it under the question answer section. I'll also be answering there. Meanwhile, Sagar can join us. Okay, so we have one question. Does MCA ROC accept the signature on the documents which are attached to the e-forms as attachments? Sir, I might not be sure of this, but the electronic signatures which are there as per the recent IT Act and 2008, the electronic signatures are now accepted in any documents. And I can share with you that specific announcement that has been
No, I mean,
recently
are you registered for the
published.
webinar now? Rikakesha, मेरे को बोल रहा है, she's not able to see you in the attendee, but she is the organizer, she is supposed to unmute you.
Yes. So we have one more question. How can we contact your organization further? So, sir, I'm sharing with you the email address. You can just post all your questions and queries and inquiries over here. So we have one more question from Ms. Shivangi. What platform is the solution available on? So ma'am, this is a blockchain-based solution. Ethereum is the platform on which it is built. And yes, it is available on cloud as well as on-premise. Both the options are available. Further, we can discuss on which offering would suit you the best. It would be great if you can share your email address or phone number. So we have one more question from Ms. Smriti Gupta. This will be on cloud or on-prem solution, or both the options are there? Ma'am, we have both the options available. This solution can be provided on cloud as well as on-premise. So we have one more question from Mr. Subhash Kedia. What are the charges for signature? So, sir, we will be discussing about the pricing options which are there right after the demonstration is over. So if you can just give us 20, 15, 20 more minutes for us to walk you through the demonstration of the product. So we have one more question from Mr. Jinesh Jain, asking whether we will be able to digitally sign the document offline utility on our server without uploading the documents in cloud server. So, sir, in that case, we also have one more of our applications, which is an offline tool. So for that is a server based application. For signature as a blockchain based platform, you will definitely be requiring the internet connectivity. It is not possible offline, whether you are opting for an on cloud solution or an on-premise solution. Okay, we have one more question: whether class 2 DST can be used for digitally signing the document? Yes, sir. Any dongle or hardware is compatible for signing these documents. And if you're using or going for the certified sign, you do not even require the hardware right now. Yes, Sagar. So I think we are now able to hear you.
You can hear me?
Yes.
Great. Wow. So just give me a moment. I'll quickly open the screen. So I have, sorry, I have to shift my laptop. Yeah. So are there any unanswered questions, Kesha, that I have missed?
Okay, so in terms of questions, more or less we have answered. There are a couple of questions in terms of the legality. So if you can just catch up with your challenges, and further we can discuss about the legalities as well.
Okay, perfect. Makes sense. I'll do that. Kisha, are you sharing the screen for the PPT? Actually, I'm using another laptop. I have sent the mail, but it will take a minute.
Yeah, sure. Just a second.
That would be great.
Sagar, if you have clicked on the presenter as a video or maybe other webcam, can you please close that down so I can start sharing my screen?
Yeah, just I cannot see. No, I have not. Can you now?
Yeah, just a second. Yeah, Kesha, is the screen visible now? Just a
Kesha?
second. Just a second, Sagar. Hope everybody is able to see the screen now. And Sagar, you can continue with the presentation.
Perfect. Thank you so much, and sorry for the inconvenience. So, to start with today, we all are aware of the ongoing situation of the coronavirus, and primarily it has affected largely how the way we work. One of the challenges our CA fraternity, so I am also CA Sagar Shah, we have faced is in providing the hard copies and the signed copies of the certificates or the reports that we make or the ones we are working on to our clients. Luckily, ICAI addressed this early and came up with a solution for all of us, and that's exactly why we had a discussion today. So let me get to electronic signatures and their legal validity over the other countries in the world and how they started. So as we see, they started in USA, and since 1999, they have made electronic signatures valid and legal for all the documentations and the report formations. As we see, in 2008, the Information Technology Act 2008 in India even made electronic signatures valid for India. Moving ahead, I would want to talk about the recent announcement by the ICAI. In the recent announcement by the ICAI, it has allowed use of electronic signatures for signing audit reports and certificates. Reference has been provided in this announcement to few sections of the Information Technology Act 2000 and Indian Evidence Act 1872. Kesha, can we move to the next slide? So as we see here, they have primarily mentioned the conditions here under which the electronic signature that we are talking about would be legal and would be considered as valid, and few situations mentioned where the signature would not be considered as a valid signature or its legal recognition will not be in stand. What one more important point that we have to note here is about the UDIN. Many people had this question that if you are electronically signing a document, does the UDIN requirement of the government remain compulsory? So yes, ICAI has made it very clear that the UDIN creation on the ICAI portal and mentioning the same on both manually and digitally signed copies and certificates, including those certificates that we are even uploading online, is compulsory. So though you are uploading the audit report or the documents online, the UDIN creation on the ICAI portal and mentioning of the same on the certificate or the report that you're providing to the client would be compulsory. Moving a little ahead to the specific difficulties in the documentations that we are facing, I would want to show the next document slide. Kesha, can we move to the next slide? So talking about few documents which we need to provide to the clients in this lockdown period and their importance. Firstly, coming to tax audit reports. Now, hard copies of the same may not have been provided to the clients and the same may be required for internal audit or management records. Also, during this lockdown, a lot of loan applications for cash flow and working capital constraints are being done by the clients, and tax audit report, being a very crucial financial statement of the company, is a necessity in the same. The banks or the financial institutions would never accept a non-signed copy of the tax audit report or the financials, the balance sheet and the P&L account, though they would have the DAC signature there. That would suffice the uploading of the document onto the income tax website and the government portal. But they would compulsorily require you to still electronically sign the document by the chartered accountant who's carried out the audit. Moving to turnover certificates, net worth certificates. A lot of clients who are into filing online tenders or online work orders, works contracts, need to provide these certificates for the turnover for the last few years or the net worth certificates to be applicable for a particular audit or to be applicable for a particular order. This can now be done by signing electronically and providing the document. Coming to the GST audit reports, we are still filing the GST audit reports for financial year 18-19 due to the delays and have recently filed the financial year 17-18 audit reports. Maybe most of the audit reports hard copies have still not been provided to the client, keeping in mind that most of them were filed in the January, Jan and early Feb. Now these can be easily provided to the clients by signing on them electronically, primarily to those companies where they would require hard copies of the same to be submitted now, which would be submitted in mail or on soft copies to the officers for refund applications. So any type of refund applications, if you are making for a particular period for which there is a delay, the client would again need to submit this in hard copy post uploading of the same on the GST portal. Next one, again being an important and a crucial one, as we know, the 15 CACB copies. Now this is primarily for the foreign payments or the foreign transfers, remittances that are being made from India. A lot of foreign parent companies require some remittances to be made back to them abroad from India, and these remittances cannot be stopped or the business cannot be delayed because the 15 CACBs are not available. So post the 15 CACB online uploading, The CV copy can be provided to the clients through these electronic signatures. Last, you know, in the exhaustive list, I would come to the statutory audit reports, the projected statements that most of the companies right now need for internal discussion purposes, for board meetings, for the last quarter, for the last financial year. Keeping in mind the situation, this data is crucial for the companies to take a lot of decisions. So they are going to require the hard copies of these. The above which I have mentioned is not an exhaustive list, and we need to support clients only businesses in this tough time. For this, we have a solution called Signature. Kesha, I believe, has shown you a lot of slides through which she's shown you the product about Signature and how it really works. So Kesha, if you can just, you know, complete the product part of it, and then we can take up the questions.
We'll walk through the demonstration. Before that, we have a couple of questions for you in terms of the legality, if you would like to throw some light, whether
sure. So from the legal perspective, first on a generalized mode, I'll just you know, share with you guys what the ICAI says. So it is clearly mentioned in the section 3A electronic signature that we talked, that the signature will be considered reliable and will be in the specified second, the second schedule which they have mentioned in the announcement. Just few points I'll share with the team about where they have said that okay, this would be a legal signature and plus it will be a valid electronic signature. One of them being the signature creation data or the authentication of the data at the time of signing are under the control of the signatory. So if it is proven at a later stage that the signatory did not have full control or the control was jeopardized, then in that case, this electronic signature would not be considered as a valid signature. One more important point they have mentioned is that if there was any alteration to the information made after its authentication by the electronic signature, and that is easily traceable and detectable, then it will be considered as a valid signature, or in that case, again, it will be considered as an invalid electronic signature. So just to make it easy for understanding and not going into the detailed electronic signature rules, because for that we'll have to get into the Information Technology Act, to be very fair. But just mentioning that any kind of jeopardize when our CA fraternity was signing on the document physically, and there were any kind of jeopardized happening there. Similarly, on the electronic end, they have kept these norms where any kind of signing, if later on realized was jeopardized or not done by the was not in control of the signatory, will be considered as an invalid one. But if anyone has any specific questions on this, we would address it situation wise.
Okay, we have one more question for you, whether the signature utility helps in generation of UDIN on ICAI portal while uploading the document and digital signing. So
okay, so yeah, Kesha, should I go forward with this one?
Yeah, sure.
Perfect. Okay, so there are two things here. The UDIN is a completely separate activity, and I'm sorry, but this utility does not create the UDIN, primarily because if it had to, the user ID and the password of the chartered accountant would have to be shared in the utility, and that information would not want to be generally shared. Two, the ICAI is generating this, and the signature which is being generated is completely different entity. So no, the UDIN will have to be made separately. But yes, once you have the UDIN along with you in the document, that can be the UDIN number can be posted through the columns or the updates into the electronically or the digitally signed document which you're going to be having. You'll have to mention it separately. It can be added onto the document.
Okay, one more question. Does MCA ROC accept the signature on the documents which are attached to e-forms as attachments?
Yes. So ideally, see, up to now, this was a big problem because no, they were not. You had to physically sign and upload it. As I read the announcement, so unluckily, we don't have a detailed notification on this yet. We have the announcement 3-page document from the ICAI, which is being rolled out. But they have very clearly mentioned here that all the reports and the certificates. Now, going by these two words, I would say that any certificate or any acknowledgement which you are uploading on the MCA website for annual reports or anything should be easily allowed by the, like, from the electronic signature point of view. Coming on to the MCA thing, MCA website, if we refer to the Information Technology Act, electronic signature was always considered as a valid signature as per the Indian government. So yes, it would be considered. You can use an electronic signature here for uploading.
Okay, sure. The next question is again technical in nature. So whether that is compatible for iOS and Android? Yes, it is compatible for both iOS and Android. You will just require a browser. Any version will work for signing. And if you sign a PDF, any user, whether they are on Mac or Windows, they will be able to view the same. We have one more question stating, is it mandatory for the receivers to have signature installed to authenticate the signature? No, it is not. They can even sign by signing in as a guest. And no, it is not required that they have to register on signature so that they can view or rather authenticate the document. That will anyway happen. Authentication will anyway happen. Okay, we have one more question stating, is bulk signing of documents like invoices with the help of a class 2 signature possible? So Mr. Ankur, if you can share your details. We have one more of our application which is related to bulk signing, and it's a server based application, so we can discuss it with you in person. Again, it is a separate product, so maybe we can have one more webinar for it, and I'll get in touch with you personally for it. So please share your email address or your mobile number. We have one more question. What is the validity of these signatures? So basically, you will be able to see a validity certificate. It is going to be validated by Global Sign. So it does not have any restriction of, as of now, for the time period of its validity. We have one more question stating, the financial statements are to be signed by the directors first, and then the auditor has to sign the same. In this case, how the e-signs will be done? So, sir, in this case, what will happen is we will put the director as the first person to place the sign. Once the director signs, then and only then the auditor can sign. So that kind of a setting can be done over here. It's just a matter of a single click. So do you offer a SaaS-based product, Mr. Ram? No, this is a cloud-based version for majorly built on .NET and blockchain usage as a technology. However, I'll confirm back to you on this shortly. Please help me with your email address as well. Okay, we can take up the next questions post the demonstration. I'll just showcase quickly the demonstration. So this is signature. I have logged in with my credentials and entering the OTP. And once I entered signed in over here, I'll be able to see a dashboard. In the dashboard, I'll be able to see that how many other documents that have been uploaded till date, how many I have sent for signing further, how many other documents wherein I need to sign, how many other documents that have been completed, and the details regarding the unsigned documents, or as for the subscription details, what are the subscription details, how many documents are remaining. All of these basic details will be available over here. So as a next step for signing any document, I just need to click on choose file. I can just select any of the PDF copies or the Word copies that are available over here. So I'll just select one of the standard agreements which is there. Or maybe So this file has gotten uploaded over here. So once the file is uploaded, from here I'll be able to select the signers. So say suppose I have selected Kesha as one signer. I can select any other signer who's there, and if in case I have not added any signer, I can just add using the email address of a person as well. So I'm just adding a user over here. This user may not be using the signature as a platform. That is fine. So from here, I can save a contact. As soon as the contact is saved over here, I'll be able to view that contact. And I've already added him as a signer. Now, as we had received one question on this, if the director wants to sign first and then and only then the auditor, we can have a sequential signing wherein the director only can sign first and then the auditor can sign. If you want that any person can sign anytime, that is the parallel order. And if in case there has to be an approver of it, either of the two parties can be an approver, you can select one. If you want to just have description along with the document you have uploaded, you can have that done over here. In case you want to attach any supporting documents along with the document that needs to be signed, you can just put attach a document, choose a file from your desktop or maybe Dropbox or Google Drive. And once these details are done, you will be able to save and next. So here you can select e-signature or whichever signature you would want to add. Whether you also want to have location binding set as well. So you can define the area where exactly you want the other person to be when they are signing the document. Enable co-signing, having the same account. So all of these are the multiple other features that are available. You can just click on save and next. Once that is done, where do you exactly want to place the signature? So maybe I want to place my signature over here. So I can just select that. Because I have already used this application earlier, and because it's already a parallel order of signing, I'll be able to right away sign this document using my credentials, which I had used earlier. So this is how the same can be done. Can have multiple signing done as well. So now when I'm talking about where I want Yogesh to sign, I can have his sign here as well. If I want to change, if I want to draw any sign when I'm selecting my sign, I'll be able to do that as well. So I'm just showing you multiple options that are available. And if I want to sign on all the 14 pages at a single go, I can just select on sign on all pages. And once this is done, you will be able to finish the same. If you want to set a due date to it, that I want to have this document signed within 2 days itself and send the reminder on both the days, I'll be able to set that as well. So say suppose if we will definitely be maintaining audit trails of this, but if you want that the document should not be stored on signature on a common cloud, you can just click on remove signed document from the cloud. And thus this specific document will be removed from signature cloud. And once the whole process is set, you can click on finish. Yes, so this document specifically is preview in progress. Now, when I move back to my dashboard, just to complete the whole cycle. I'm showing one of the documents that are available with me for signing. So over here, so these are the notifications that we will be receiving via an email. Yes, so here, because this is a document that I personally need to sign, I can select any of these fonts or maybe draw any signature that I want to, upload any image, copy, etc. So this is available to me. So I'll just select any of these signs and click on done. And once this is done, I can click on submit. So currently the whole process is getting validated. A unique hash will be created and stored under the blockchain. And this, along with the timestamp and latitude, longitude, along with my IP address, everything is going to be stored. So once I click on continue, here the whole process of signing the document will be done. Because there might be some other signers who are also left or yet to sign the document, I will not be able to see the completion certificate. So here, for this specific document, I can click on that specific signer to remind them that this specific document needs to be signed. And once it is signed, the same can be further used as a certificate, which can be verified. Now, once I click on verify, I can click on the original document, upload the same and verify to make comparisons between the original document and the one that is uploaded by the signer. So this is how the whole signing application would work like. Moving on to the ones that are completed documents. So these are the ones that are completed. And because you are here able to see that the documents are signed by both the parties, you will be able to download that signed document as well as the certificate of the same. So once you click on the certificate, you will be able to see that both the parties or the signers have signed the document, the IP address, the browser of the document, the device, as well as the time zone and the latitude as well as the longitude details if you have selected for the same. So further, you can use this hash as well to view the uploaded document as well as the signed document. So this is a certificate further, which can be downloaded and printed and shared as well. And this is legally admissible as well. So this is how signature works like. So we are open to answer all the questions and queries that you have. I'm muting myself. You can post all your questions and we'll be happy to address the same. Okay, we have one more question stating for e-signing of the financial statements by the clients and the auditors, whether all the clients of the CA need to have to subscribe to your platform. No, sir, that is not required. They'll be able to sign as a guest as well. They do not need to subscribe for anything. So, sir, this specific utility is cloud-based as well as on-premise, but this is not a server-based utility. In case you are talking about wherein you want to bulk sign and have a single or one side sign only, there's a separate application. So we can discuss that separately. But in case of a two-way signing and remote signing access wherein there is certified sign or e-sign or digital sign in place, this is the blockchain-based application that we are having currently. And this is available on cloud and on-premise, not a server-based utility. So we have one more question stating what is an on-premise option. So basically, the whole application is deployed in your premise using your hardware and server. But however, that is not recommended. This is only recommended when you have huge volumes, maybe in thousands and lakhs. But the same is commercially also a little costlier in terms of updating and upgrading the same application. So you can share the number of documents with us, and maybe we can have a call to understand and help you or assist you with the best possible option for you, whether on cloud or on premise. So we will discuss about the pricing then. So basically, the subscription price would be that has to be this has to be paid and this has to be paid annually. So basically, that is 750 per user per month, and it is 8,250 per year plus GST that is applicable additionally. Document size that is made available for the maximum use is 15 MB. Apart from that, for each and every sign that is made, if it is an Aadhaar e-sign, it will be 350 rupees for 10 signatures. If it is a certified sign, it will be 200 rupees for 10 signatures. For live signatures, it will be the whole video conferencing experience, it will be 1500 for 10 sessions. And then further, if you want additional documents also to be uploaded, there are various packs that in which you can select multiple documents that you want to upload. So these are the pricing package. And if you want any other functionalities to be added, we can discuss that on case-to-case basis. I will share with you the pricing details as well as the signature details. There were a couple of people who were also having issues with the video and audio. So sorry for the inconvenience today. I'll also be sharing with you the recorded version of the webinar. If anybody has any more questions, they can post it into the question answer section. I'll be waiting for a couple of more minutes and then we'll be concluding with the webinar. Okay, so I understand we have no more questions. So I have shared the email addresses with you, to all of you. For any further queries, you can write it back to us at hello@signature.in. And further, in case of any queries, you can connect back with me as well. Thank you for having us, or rather, thank you for your time as well. And we will be shortly coming up with one of our other tax technology products next week in the webinar. So do stay tuned for the same. Thank you.